what I want to talk about is that in the years that I've been doing Panchpura Tech and the other community things, there's a lot of interesting things that I learned about myself and about how things work, which I feel would be useful to share with technologists, right? So basically, all of this started when I was working in Symantec Veritas, and what I felt at that time, it was such a big company doing so much cool work, and there were so many different groups, all of them doing really world-class products, and I didn't really know what was going on in most of the company except, you know, my group and maybe a few other groups where I had friends. So I felt this was just, you know, so much, I was missing so much. There were so many smart people working on so many cool things and I needed to find out more. So I started taking the effort to go around and talk to people in other groups to find out what they were working on. And while I was doing that, I realized that most of the other people, I mean, I assume that this was because I was one of the people who joined the company kind of late and a whole bunch of the seniors had been around since 90s in this company. But then I found out that a lot of the people in the company also didn't really know what is going on elsewhere. And so I decided that whenever I go and talk to somebody and find out about what they're doing, I'll just write it up and put it up, right? So that it will help other people also. Plus, you know, I used to spend a lot of time on the internet reading Slashdot and other such websites. And whenever I found something interesting which, you know, people in technology should know about, something cool, I would write up like 2-3 lines about it and put a link to the external article. And I decided that this is something that should go out to the rest of the company. I started it in Symantec, it was called Tech Forum, and an interesting thing I did there was that I didn't bother asking the company IT to set a website up for me or even give me a server or anything. I just created a web server on a machine that I had under my desktop and I just set up a blog there. I found some mailing list that already existed in the company that went out to everybody and I started sending weekly mails to everyone, right? And that worked extremely well. By the time IT decided that they should do something about this, it was already well established and management was wanted this to continue, so there was no way IT could shut it down. I mean, that was one of my first lessons, which is, I mean, it's a common lesson. Ask for forgiveness, not permission. You know, if you want, something needs to be done, just go ahead and do it. Don't wait around to figure out, okay, whom should I ask for permission, who will tell me, should I check with my manager? That's not how the world works, that's not how you should be working. The other thing there was that, you know, when I first felt that, oh, that it would be so great to have a website which gives all of this information in one place, somebody should do it. That's your clue. Whenever you think somebody should do it, ask yourself, why are you not doing it and what is stopping you from doing it? Most of the times, the answer is that you feel you don't have the time to do it. That's not really true. I mean, just a little bit of time every day and you can achieve quite a lot. Because, I mean, when I quit Symantec in around 2007, I decided that this thing worked so well that I need to do it for Pune at large. I had already bought the domain name Pune Tech in like 2006, just because I thought it was a very cool domain name and would be useful someday. And then a year and a half later, I ended up actually starting Pune Tech. I pretty much did this. Whenever I found out anything interesting about technology that is relevant to Pune, I would put it up on the blog. The intent, again, I really wanted to create a Wikipedia of technology in Pune. So I had actually set up a wiki using the same software as Wikipedia. And I thought that it may take probably 6 months for the wiki to really start. In the meantime, why don't I start a blog so that there is something getting updated on the site every day. Sadly, the wiki never took off. I tried very hard, but other than me and maybe a couple other people, then nobody really contributed to the wiki. So finally, after 4 or 5 years, I had to shut down the wiki. In that sense, it was a colossal failure. But the blog, which was supposed to be just a stopgap thing for the first 6 months, now that took off so well that I mean that's what Podetech is now. So that was the other thing, that failure comes. Failure is common, it happens all the time. But you need to keep trying different things. You don't know what thing will succeed. The thing that you think is a throwaway thing ends up succeeding, and the thing that you put all your effort in ends up failing. So the lessons there for me were that you have to keep trying things, many different things, and don't take the failure too personally. The other thing that I learned was while I was going around, at some point I started doing this seriously, as in, you know, I would go around whenever I meet somebody, I would think, okay, you know, which company does he work for? Do they do any interesting stuff? Can I write a blog about it on Podetech? And while my intention there was, okay, I need articles to put on Podetech, what I realized a little later was that I am also learning quite a lot while doing this. And this ties in very well with a bunch of psychological experiments which have been done. And I'll give you a simple thought here, right? If today I catch these two guys here and I tell them that it is your job to write an article about each and every talk that happens in IndicTreads today, right? You have to write a one paragraph article about each talk by the end of the day. They will sit there and they will listen to the talks and they'll write the articles. 6 months later, the articles might be forgotten. But 6 months later, if I quiz everyone in the room about what they learned at IndicTreads, those two guys will be the ones who remember the most. Those are the ones who will have benefited the most from the conference. Right? This happens all the time. When somehow you are told that you are doing this so that you can go and teach somebody else, you end up learning quite a lot. So that's another important thing to keep in mind. And a more generalization of that is that if you go around trying to help other people, trying to figure out what does that person need to succeed, that's a very easy path to your own success. Helping other people succeed makes you succeed much faster. So keep that in mind. Too many people I see are focusing more on, okay, how does this help me? It's not the right way to think about things. If you just do things that help you directly, you'll end up doing very few things and most of them will fail. And the way, I mean, when you start a blog or something, you know, and the reason I'm talking about starting a blog is because it is something everybody should do. Do an internal company blog if you want, or you can do an external one. You end up learning a lot, but there is also a very interesting network effect. After a little while, once Podetech started getting known, what started happening is that people start coming to me for information. Oh, do you know anybody who works in big data in Pune? Maybe that day I don't know, but I make a note that, okay, big data, people are asking for big data. So whenever next I have a few hours to spare, I poke around a little, try to search for big data. I ask Suhas, do you have anybody in your company working on big data? And I end up finding out what is going on in Pune about big data. So now, not only have I answered that person's question, my knowledge about what is happening in Pune has increased, and I maybe even put it up on the blog. So just because people are now essentially forcing me to increase my knowledge. And then the reverse also starts happening. People are working on something interesting and they want publicity for it. They come to me and tell me, can you put this up on the blog? So even without making a lot of effort, I start getting more and more knowledge just because now I'm the center of that ecosystem, right? That's a very powerful effect. The thing to remember though is that it takes time. It takes 6 months, 8 months, or a little more. And during that time, you just have to keep going at it. I still remember that when the first event I arranged for Podetech, it was actually quite a good speaker, Jason Goldberg, who had worked in the Clinton administration, who had started a very cool startup. Three people showed up. Okay, the only reason it wasn't a complete embarrassment was because I had set it up in the in True Sparrow Systems, with whom Jason was working, and like 10 people from True Sparrow Systems were there, so at least it looked like there were 15 people, although in reality there were only 3 people from outside. You know, again, utter failure, but I kept at it. And today, I think 2 weeks ago, with a bunch of other people, we arranged Pune Connect, and 500 people showed up, and it's no big deal to, you know, get 500 people to come for an event. So it takes time, just have to persevere. Again, for the blog, I still remember the day getting very excited about the fact that we reached a readership of 100. And now it's, you know, past 10,000, and I don't even look closely at how much it is. So just hang in there. Initially, it seems like you're doing this, it's not having any impact. You just have to get past that stage, right? That is the chasm that Suhas was talking about. The first 10 guys to read your blog are the early adopters. But then you need, then there is a chasm after which the mainstream people will start reading your blog. It takes some time to get there, and you need to work on that. And last thing I wanted to say was, like Suhas mentioned, the two things that have made me sort of known are the iTrans songbook, the Hindi lyrics page that I created, and Pune Tech. Both of these are things that I did as a hobby. I mean, when I was doing my PhD, working on some fancy complex database stuff, parallel object relational databases, in my free time, I used to solve these lyrics quizzes on the internet, where somebody would post a line from the middle of a song, and you had to guess what the song was. And I had found this database of songs as a one big zip file. So I decided that, you know, this would be a great way to solve this these quizzes, to have a searchable HTML version of this songbook. So I sat and I converted it all to HTML, I put it up on a website, and before I knew it, like tens of thousands of people were reading that site. It was just a side hobby that I did, and I also decided that that was a good way for people to learn Perl, right? And it became far bigger than I had expected. Again, Pune Tech similarly started off as a simple blog, and I said, okay, let me do this in my free time. And it's still something I do in my free time, but it has taken off far more than I expected. Another example we saw just earlier this morning, Harshal pointed out that they had a software consulting and development company, and in their extra time, almost as a hobby, they started Indic Threads. And if I'm not mistaken, today Indic Threads is far bigger than for them than their other activities, right? So it is important to have hobbies other than your work, related to technology, I would say, right? You should have hobbies because you don't know where the next big thing is going to come out of. It's most likely going to be from your hobby, because that's what you do passionately. The work you are doing because someone is paying you. So I just want to summarize, which is, don't wait for someone else to do it. Seek forgiveness, not permission. Just go ahead and do things. Fail often. Failure. You notice that I kept failing at different things. I mean, I bought Pune Tech 2 years before I actually started Pune Tech. I have 10 other domain names which I have not done anything with, or some that I have done something with and they failed pretty badly, right? So you fail 9 times, that's the way to succeed the 10th time. So you have to learn to fail gracefully and not take it too personally and get depressed about it. Help others, that's the way to really succeed yourself, and have hobbies, okay? So that's all I had to say. I would like to thank Indic Threads. This is a great honor. Thanks, Harshad, Sangeeta, and Indic Threads. Since this is the first one, so I'm